Hello friends, in this video I wanted to show you about the new design. This is an extension or an upgraded version of the VALTALK device which we designed earlier. Earlier VALTALK device had 4 relays on it and they were able to be controlled by using a GSM module. So you can call the GSM module and the device will answer the call and you can control the 4 relays which are present on the board using the DTMF tones. And this board is also similar, except that the relays have been moved from this board to this board. So this is called the hub board and this is the node board. These two boards communicate using Wi-Fi. Earlier, this design was done because in the earlier design, the GSM module was directly controlling the relays on the same board. Suppose if you are doing a building automation project and you needed to control multiple switchboards, then that time it would have been a problem. At that time you would need one GSM module on each board and multiple SIM cards. So that would not be economical. So we added a Wi-Fi module as an extension here. Wi-Fi is inexpensive. Almost every household or an office has a Wi-Fi connection now. So these Wi-Fi modules can connect to the existing Wi-Fi network and they can communicate with each other using IP addresses. You can also make the Wi-Fi module connect to the internet and this can also become an MQTT client or a subscriber and this module will publish commands to it through MQTT and this will receive it and activate the two relays. To tell about the boards, this is the same VALTALK board except the addition of the Wi-Fi module here and this is running on a 12-volt input. You can give 12-volt adapter input here. And then it will be reduced to 5 volts and then this regulator will reduce it to 4 volt needed by the GSM module and the Wi-Fi module. Wi-Fi is again getting 3 volts from the 3 volt regulator. This is the MP3 player which was used in the VALTALK board. This will play the MP3 files present on the SD card through the audio call using the GSM module. The mic input of the GSM module is connected to the MP3 player output. ESP8266 is controlled by STM32L4 series MCU. This MCU was selected because it needed to have 3 EWARTs, 1 EWART to control the MP3 recorder and the other EWART to control the GSM module and the other EWART to control the ESP module. And there are pins provided for programming the ESP8266 and also to program the STM32 microcontroller. The SIM card supported on this board is the micro SIM slot. This is the micro SIM connector. And on the other side, you can see that this board is having 2 relays on it, 2 cube relays. They are 12 volt relays. You can see here. These relays are controlled by MOSFETs. One MOSFET is here and another one is here. It also has a temperature sensor on board wherein you can call to the hub board and the hub board will receive the call and if you select the option to read the temperature sensor from any particular node, then what it will do is it will read the temperature value through the Wi-Fi and then it will play the audio of the temperature value present on this board. So the LM75 temperature sensor was added here. This board also runs on 12 volt input. The MP1584 will reduce it to 4 volt and the 3 volt regulator present here will convert it to 3 volt for the operation of the ESP8266. There is no separate MCU on this because ESP is directly controlling the relays and talking to the Wi-Fi on the other board. The terminal connectors provided here can be used to connect AC appliances like bulbs, fans or anything you think of. Headers are provided for programming the ESP8266 and one small level translator was added for programming the chip. Otherwise, the ESP8266 IO levels are limited to 3.3 volts, so we added a level translator for that to keep it safe. Now, let me show you a demo on how this one works, how the two boards communicate. Now, let us power the devices one by one. First, we'll power the hub with the 12 volt adapter. Now you can see that the GSM module has started blinking. Now it will the 1 second blink indicates that it's searching for network. When the LED becomes stable, like when it starts blinking every 3 seconds, then it has registered to the network. So now it's registered. It will blink only every 3 seconds. Now this LED is an indicator LED used for the controller. And on the other side, let us power the ESP board also. There is some bug on this ESP module or code, I don't know. Whenever the ESP module is booted up, it will turn the IO pins high. That's why the relays are turning on whenever we boot it up. If you have any idea why this is happening and how we can fix it, you can comment on the video and we can discuss. So now I will call to the device to the number inserted on the SIM card here.
Welcome. Press 1 to control device number 1. Press 2 to control device number 2. Press 3 to temperature rating. You selected device number 1. Press number 1, turn on. Press number 2, turn off. Device number 1, turned on. Press number 2, turn off. Press hash to go main menu. Welcome. Press 1 to control device number 1. Press 2 to control device number 2. Press 3 to temperature rating.
Now I'll select device 2.
You selected device number 2. Press number 1, turn on. Press number 2, turn off.
Let's turn it on.
Device number 2, turned on. Press number 2, turned on. Press hash to go main menu.
Okay, now let us turn the device number 1 off again.
Welcome, press 1 to control device number 1. Press 2 to control device number 2. Press 3 to temperature rating. You selected device number 1. Press number 1, turn on. Press number 2, turn off.
I'll turn it off now.
Device number 1, turned off. Press number 1, turn on. Press hash to go main menu. Welcome. Press 1 to control device number 1. Press 2 to control device number 2. Press 3 to temperature rating.
Now I'm turning off device 2.
Number 2. Press number 1, turn on. Press number 2, turn off.
Okay, device number 2 has been turned off.
Press number 1, turn on. Press hash to go main menu.
Now we'll go to the main menu and again test the temperature reading.
Press 1 to control device number 1. Press 2 to control device number 2. Press 3 to temperature rating.
Okay, now let us read the temperature.
Temperature is 29 degrees Celsius.
So that's the correct temperature right now. Now the temperature was read from this board and it was given to the GSM board through the Wi-Fi network. Okay, now I will disconnect the call. Okay, that's all there is for now. I will keep you guys posted on further developments of this board. If you have any questions regarding this board, you can drop me a mail to ravi@valtron.com. And if you have any technical queries, you can ask on my forum www.embeddedadvice.com. And you can also check more content about this board. And if you want to buy this board, it will be available on valtron.com/store. And more details will be posted on my blog www.ravyyp.com. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.